Dixon. I mean, even when he recognizes the players, you don't even know where the players come from. Nobody's watching the Swedish League or the KHL or juniors. Sorry, Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds hockey. I guess I didn't buy the hockey package. Nobody knows the players. They appear on your team. What percentage of the league is foreign? That plays a role. We don't know these guys. 6-7 teams are up in the North Pole because for most Americans, they couldn't find Winnipeg, Edmonton, Calgary, Vancouver. They couldn't find these places on a map. It is what it is. Unfortunately, we don't have an MLS team here. If we did, I think it'd be popular. I think it would work. But in towns that have them, they're getting interest. They're getting people to their games. You know, now, can you get Americans to watch it on TV? Again, probably not. The attention span. It's a tough sell.
It leads to F that. Hockey has the best playoffs, period. You guys.
Just for you. Nobody cares. That's why your playoff games are on CNBC with Jim Cramer on the call.
Right.
All right. Booyah. All right. Let me tell you something we all agree on. Vegas, it's cool. I don't know when we'll be back. It's open. You can come back today if you really desire. Check out thed.com. The D is up. Derek was flying people out there left and right. Sportsbook, all the things you remember. They're all there. It's a little different, of course, with masks and basketball. It is there. And if there was Vegas, there would be football. And if there's football, there's the Circus Sports Media. Get all the details at GoldenGateCity.com. I'm not going to take you through the details of each contest, but you got the Pick'em, $3 million prize pool, picking games against the spread. You got the Survivor. You know the Survivor. You want the information, go to GoldenGateCasino.com. You want to check out Vegas, give the D a shot. TheD.com, book your stay today. It's TheD.com, the D Las Vegas. It's home for sports in Vegas.
1-800-POWER-90 and get an additional $1,800 off. Generac and Power Home Solar, let the sun shine in.
Switch to Wow Superfast Internet 200 for $44.99 per month. More speed for a low price with a safe, contact-free installation and local tech support. Details at Huawei.com.
Wow.
Text the ticket using the same number you use to call the ticket. Ticket text 248-539-9797.
Specifically the helmets, all right? So, I want to ask
you, helmet-nista.
Any guesses on the 32-ranked team?
Baltimore Ravens, lock it up. Worst helmet in the history of sports.
Really?
That stupid bird logo's been around for 30 years. God-awful. Ravens.
The Ravens are not, which is kind of interesting because 32 is another uniform ranking. It had the Redskins there as well. So it's the Redskins at 32. But
right, that's because of the logo. All right, okay, fine. Redskins are the worst. Ravens are the next one.
Now, the Ravens, I'm sorry to tell you, the Ravens are ranked number 7 in this. The 7th best helmet.
I'm out on this point. Not interested in Bertha Spence. How? What is the justification? That thing is a crime against artwork.
Yeah, I can read you at least what they say.
Please
Ravens
don't.
Here at number 7. Once again, a profile shot of a bird. But this one looks more menacing, kind of reminiscent of Lord of the Rings. So they get the nod over the Seahawks.
Wow. You know what I would challenge our listeners to do? Pull up the Ravens logo. Pull up that helmet. You stare at that and tell me if that bird looks menacing. The bird looks like he's on an Adderall trip. Like, enough. Bird sucks. Next.
I want you to guess where both the New York teams are. I know you're from New York. Where are the New York teams
at? See, the shame is I like the Jets' old helmets. The new helmet is better than the uniform, so I would probably put the Giants and Jets in the top half of the league. I don't love either. I don't hate either. So that I would place them both middle of the pack.
Well, Jets are 30th, and the Giants are 28.
Oh, my God.
Here's what they say, NBC says about the Giants. The only thing exciting about these lids is that the one on David Tyree's head once kept Tom Brady and the Patriots from going 19-0.
So basically what? We're going to rip teams that are classical? We want to bury the Steelers because it's not exciting? What's the Jets' problem? Shiny, metallic, sharp font?
The Jets.
What's the issue?
Says we've gone from Washington's offensive logo to the Browns' plain colors to just words. Nothing more inspiring than putting four words and a football on your head to go charge into another team at full speed. Next.
What are you supposed to put on there? A map? Something interactive? What are you supposed to do? Mike, I tell you, we're off to a bad start with this list.
Now, the Steelers you just mentioned, let me highlight where they're
at. The best helmet in football.
Steelers actually are way down, I guess you'd say, at number 19. Here's why. Being historic and iconic can only get you so far. The Steelmark logo just isn't all that exciting. I know some people out there who are looking for their teeth are going to tell me how it's one of the most iconic in all of sports. I don't care.
Jesus.
Very critical list. I like it.
Okay, well, I want to know who the hell's popular. Jesus.
Okay, well, let's go just outside of the top 10, and we'll dive into the top 10 here in a moment. At number 12, we have the Detroit Lions helmet as the 12th best in the NFL.
Stop.
The lion's a good look on the silver lid, but I'd prefer a more front-facing, snarling lion. Maybe that's just me, though.
Listen, Lions logo is, in my world, one of the 10 worst in all sports. It's pathetic. I mean, think about it. You are the Lions, one of the most fearsome beasts on the globe. Okay, the king of the jungle. Look at your logo. Who does that scare? Is anyone proud to rock that logo? Like, is it a cool logo? No. So it's not cool, and it's not scary. Bubbles has always been a chump. And, I mean, that's just where I stand on it. Like, it's tough if you're a Charlotte Hornets and your logo's a bumblebee. You're not really going to be able to do much with that. You know, you're the Lions. It should be easy.
Now, I mentioned the Ravens were 7, then they were just a couple spots ahead of the Seahawks, who were 10.
Seahawks is a good one, and it's not even a real bird.
Well, just before we get into the top 5 here, number 6.
Texans have got to be on there.
The Texans actually were down at 26. They were nowhere near.
Wait, let me get this straight. You don't like a Longhorn with the state flag of Texas inside of it on a sharp navy blue helmet? What am I missing here? Or are you just changing the answer so I sound like a bigger idiot than I already am?
No, they just said it's not the worst, but really just need something more. I don't know. Not a huge description. And they mentioned Bill O'Brien, you know, taking that. This list is not, it's a funny list, but it's not the most subjective, I guess.
I'm offended.
Anyway, let's go to number 6, Buffalo Bills. Do you think they have a good one? The Charging Bill is a great logo.
No.
Great helmet.
David, do you have any issue with this, or have you just left the room because it's so offensive?
I'm not really taking a big issue with it. It's just, you know, one article that wants to just describe helmets. I think the Steelers one is better than what 19 is what they said. But other than that, you know, it is what it is.
It's Buffalo Bills.
I know.
Look at that thing.
All right, any guesses top 5? Let's see how many you can get from the top 5.
It better not be the Cowboys.
Cowboys are number 1. No, I'm just messing with that. No, the Cowboys are actually down at 18. Any other guesses? Top 5.
No, I got nothing because I clearly am just not on the same page as this writer.
Okay, let's just round out the top 5. The Falcons at number 5. Bird mascot. Dolphins at number 4. The Patriots at 3. And then the top 2, and we've seen this next team rank very high lately in uniform rankings, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers at number 2. We did a list a few weeks ago. I think they were number 4 for overall uniforms. Pirate flag, 2 swords. It's awesome.
Don't like it. If they went back to the creamsicle era, now you're on to something. Then I'd be in. People don't appreciate how great the retro Tampa Bay Bucks logo was. I know some of you are going to go, all right, Mike's lost it. I'm not. That logo is so badass. It's so ridiculous. It's so crazy to have it orange, white, with a little red on. I'm telling you, go back and look at that logo and tell me. I mean, if I could find a fitted retro Bucks hat, I'd probably buy it.
And number 1.
And I knew one kid in my grade school who had a starter Tampa Bay Bucks jacket. You could see him from 700 miles away.
Classic. There you go.
It was like fluorescent orange for days with that massive logo on the back. Friends.
Number 1 in what NBC Sports is calling a no-brainer, the Raiders. Classic.
So let me get it straight. The Raiders gets credit for being classic, but the Cowboys, the Giants, the Steelers,
and
all
the Packers, are at 25. You know, all the other classic logos are way down there. But no, NBC Sports top 32 helmets. Certainly some controversy there. Wow.
Look at this logo. I mean, it's beautiful. Mike, let me get you a Bucks t-shirt. I mean, let's get you in the mix. Look at that logo. How do you not want that? How do you not want
them? Sweet.
David, we should get matching hats with the feather on. I mean, come on. Wear them in the studio.
No, thank you.
Me and you, the day we all return to studio. Come on.
ID71
WWJ AM 950 Traffic Center. This report brought to you by the Michigan Health and Hospital Association. An accident has just been moved to the right shoulder, 696 eastbound right after Drake. There's reports of a wreck in Dearborn Heights on Ford Road westbound at Beach Daily. Also, traffic signals not working correctly at the intersection of Michigan Avenue and Haggerty Road. If you have Michigan auto insurance, big changes are coming to your medical coverage as of July 1st. Learn how to stay safe with full protection at driveprotected.org. Funded by the Michigan Health and Hospital Association. I'm Michelle Pena with traffic. 24-month lease is 10,500 miles a year. No security deposit. Total due at signing. F-150, $2,874. Fusion, $2,099. AZ plan for returning lessees, including Ford Select inventory rebates. Plus tax, title, license, and dock. With approved financing through Ford Credit. Ends July 6, 2020.
Brian Godfrey, I heard the Pat Milliken Ford showroom is now open. Is that true?
It is. We're excited to welcome Metro Detroit drivers back into our showroom, and we're taking extra precautions to ensure our customers' safety while at the dealership.
That's great to hear. And your customers can still buy online if they choose, correct?
Absolutely. Our goal is to help you find the right Ford safely and affordably, no matter which way you buy.
And right now, you have great savings going on. Lease a new 2020 Ford F-150 XLT Super Crew 4x4 Milliken Express priced from $149 a month. Or a new 2020 Ford Fusion SE, also Milliken Express priced from only $149 a month.
We're ready to help you upgrade to a new Ford today.
Start your experience online at PatMillikenFord.com or visit the dealership on Telegraph Road.
Pat Milliken Ford, over 60 years of the experience you deserve.
At Fisher Investments, we do things differently. And other money managers don't understand why.
Because our way works great for us.
But it may not work for your clients. That's why Fisher Investments is a fiduciary, obligated to put clients first. It's the highest standard for a financial advisor.
So, what do you provide? Cookie-cutter portfolios like the rest of us?
No cookie-cutter portfolios here. Fisher Investments tailors portfolios to meet each client's goals and needs.
But you do sell investments that earn you high commissions, right? And make commissions when you make trades for your clients?
No, Fisher Investments doesn't sell any commission investment products, and we never earn commissions on trades.
So what's in it for you?
Fisher Investments fees are structured so we do better when our clients do better. When it comes to helping clients achieve a comfortable retirement, we're clearly different. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments, clearly different money management.
Investments in securities involve the risk of loss.
It's time for the Drinks on Your Deck update, brought to you by Northville Lumber. It's a line drive down Hardy Field with low-maintenance Trex, your money-saving wood alternative. Keep your eye on having a ball. Score your Trex decking today at NorthvilleLumber.com.
This hour of instant feedback brought to you by Mike Capura of National Benefit Plan. For affordable life insurance, log on to NDPHealth.com.
When big things happen in Detroit sports, you hear it first on Detroit's number one sports station, 97.1 The Ticket. Breaking news powered by Radio.com Sports and brought to you by the Dell Technologies Small Business Podference. Go listen at Radio.com/Dell. WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. 97.1 The Ticket. A Radio.com sports station. Sports headlines. All day, every day. From the Hall Financial Sports Desk, this is 97.1 The Ticket.
We are brought to you by Applied Imaging. Good talks today, reportedly between Major League Baseball Commissioner Rob Manfred and Players Association Director Tony Clark. They reportedly had a productive meeting, although we don't know what came out of it. There are random reports that at least eight of the owners do not even want a 2020 season. Adding to the mix, Dr. Anthony Fauci says any season should finish by October 1st to avoid a potential second COVID wave. Lovely. Odds out to win the Big Ten title. They're updated, at least, at the Westgate Superbook. Ohio State, the favorite, 2-5. Penn State and Wisconsin, both 7-1. Michigan and Minnesota at 16-1. Michigan State University at 100-1. Meanwhile, the Detroit Tigers agreed to terms with a couple of their draft picks. Third-rounder shortstop Trey Cruz and fifth-rounder third baseman Cole Keith, both in full. And you gotta love this story. Former Detroit Red Wings star Pavel Datsyuk reportedly among those, quote, holed up at a monastery in Russia where a priest has seized control after being told to stop services due to his COVID-19 conspiracy beliefs. That's reported by Ansar Khan of MLive.com. And he's reporting that the area is being guarded with Cossacks. At the Ticket Update Desk, I'm Jeff Lesson from our 97.1 The Ticket or Radio.com.
What? Hold on. I'm not sure. Was Lesson just effing with us? Is that a real story?
real story. I just pulled it up on our website, actually.
By the way, our under looks beautiful. Arsenal, Man City, under 3.5. We're scoreless in that.
Good start. All you can ask for there. Yeah, let me pull up the details here of this story. So it's really nothing short of remarkable, I guess. But I'm reading 971theticket.com. Pavel Datsyuk reportedly holed up at a Russian monastery with rebel priest. The priest is claiming the virus is a conspiracy to microchip the public. The priest, known as Father Sergei, reportedly chased out the monastery's former leader and seized control with fighters who are guarding the perimeter of the site, according to the Moscow Times. He's been barred from public ministry in Russia after disobeying health guidelines and claiming that COVID-19 is just one big excuse to microchip the public.
Wait, so Datsyuk is friends with this guy?
So that's what I'm
saying. Wait, so he's stuck in a church that was overtaken by a madman?
No, I'm trying to find his affiliation. Father Sergei said, "I'm not going anywhere. They'll have to chase me out with police and the National Guard." Now, Datsyuk, who returned to Russia in 2016 after a 14-year career with the Red Wings, is among those at the monastery supporting the priest. Father Sergei is said to be Datsyuk's personal confessor.
What did I just say?
Yep. Yeah, so Datsyuk, but the way they phrase it, Datsyuk is reportedly holed up at a Russian monastery with a rebel priest who was once jailed for murder, who claims the virus is a conspiracy.
You cannot say he's holed up if it's, it sounds like that's right. Against his will. No, this is exactly what he wants to do right now.
Wow, this is weird. 2020, just go away.
Wow.
Now, Cossacks are the dudes who wear the hats, right? Don't they wear the hats?
No idea.
No, you know what I'm talking about. Like the ones that look like Fred Flintstone, the fur. They don't have the buffalo horns on it, but like they wear the hats. That's what Cossacks are. That's like, I think Cossacks are a specific religion.